Good morning students, welcome once again to online video class from PCHSS Baripada. So today I am going to start a topic called populations from the chapter of organisms and populations. What is population? What is population? First you have to write the definitions, or you have to mention the definition of population. It refers to the sum total of an individual of the same species occupying in a given geographical area is called populations. Okay, so who coined the term populations? A population term was coined by Clark in 1954. Who coined the term population? Clark in 1954. Okay, next, population attributes. The populations can attribute the certain things, that is called the components of the populations are what? The components of the populations, the populations can attribute certain components like natality, mortality, sex ratio, okay, and dispersals, which are concerned to what? No, populations, but it is not applicable to individuals. Okay, now population attributes. Population attributes. What are the population attributes? There are certain attributes in population, in populations where there are certain attributes in population where an individual does not possess it, where an individual does not possess it. The components of the population attributes are, first is natality, number two mortality, number three density, number four sex ratio, okay, and number five dispersal. So there are certain attributes in population where an individual does not possess it. Now, natality, mortality, density, sex ratio, and dispersals are all concerned to what? No, population attribute, but however it is not applicable to the individuals. Okay, now first you have to know about the density. What is called density? So what is called density? Density, number of individuals increasing in an area is called density, and it is denoted by symbol T. T is equal to N by S, where N stands for number of individuals increasing, and S stands for area, and S stands for what? Area. Here, so this is the definition of density. Number of individuals increasing in an area is called what? Density. Then after that, natality. What is called natality? Natality, that is what? Natality is birth rate. Natality is birth rate. Number two, natality, that is birth rate. individuals, individuals adding in an average population, in an average population is called natality, is called natality. Individuals adding in an average population is called natality. That is called a birth rate. Birth rate, that is when you person, if in a population there are 100 individuals are there and the adding of the population would be 20, then what would be the natality and what would be the natality? That is natality equal to what? So natality or birth rate. Suppose in a given area the population, initial the population is 1000 and 20 number of individuals are adding in an area, in a population. Okay? So that is called what? Natality. Natality, number of individuals increasing by average population, by average population. That is called natality. That is called what? Natality. Natality is what? That is birth rate. Birth rate is that number of individuals increasing in a population. Suppose new individuals adding to the population, suppose 20, and average populations were 1000. Suppose 1000, then what would be the natality rate? And the natality rate, by this way you have to calculate the natality rate, that the new individual which is adding to a population. So individuals adding in an average population is called natality. Suppose new individuals which are adding in a population were 20 and the initial populations were 1000. So number of individuals increasing, that is 20 by 1000. So what would be the ratio then now? 0.02. Okay? So this is the natality rate. That is called a natality rate. Then after that, mortality. Mortality means what? The death rate. Mortality is death rate. Mortality. Number of individuals decreasing due to death in an average population. That is called mortality. What is called mortality? Number of individuals decreasing due to death in an average population is called mortality. Is called mortality. Now mortality rate, suppose initially the population was 500. If a number of individuals were get perished due to some infection or due to some disease, so whatever, or due to some natural causes for aging, then the mortality rate would be what? Suppose initial population was 500 and the number of population decreasing due to natural death or getting perished is 150. Then what would be the mortality rate? Then mortality rate equal to what? Number of individual decreasing by average population. By average population. Equal to some 50 by 500. 50 by 500. Then what would be the ratio then? 1 by 10. That is 0.1. What is that? Is what? 0.1. Okay. So that is what? 0.1. Okay. That is called mortality. The first is density, then natality, then mortality. Then after mortality, sex ratio. What is called sex ratio? Number 4. Sex ratio. These are all the attributes of population. These are all the what? Attributes of the population, which are taking place naturally in a population, are called attributes, population attributes. Next is number 4, sex ratio. It refers to the number of females number of females to number of males. Remember it refers to the number of females to the number of male is called the sex ratio. Okay, it is called the sex ratio. According to census, in 2001, the sex ratio was 933 females, 933 females over 1000 males. There are a lot of variations. In sex ratio of different part of the states or different part of the countries. Okay. Next. But however, in case of animal, the sex ratio remains the same. That is, the number of males should be equal to the number of females in case of animals. But in case of animals. Sex ratio, that is number of females, is same to the number of males. Okay? Next, sex ratio. Then after that, dispersal. What is called dispersal? Dispersal means the movement of individuals. The movement of individuals in and out in a population is called dispersal. Number five, that is called dispersal. The number of individuals moving in and out of the population is called dispersal. Okay, now population dispersals are two types. It is classified into two types, that is immigration and emigration. What it is? Immigration and emigration. That is, what does the immigration and emigration stands for? Immigration means the number of the individuals moving in a population. The individuals coming to a population is called immigration, and the individuals moving out from the population is called emigration. What is the difference between immigration and emigration? Immigration means, remember, the immigration is the number of population, the number of individuals. The number of individuals increasing in a population is called immigration, and the number of individuals moving out from the population is called emigration. Okay? Moving in a simple way, I am writing here, moving in a population, or simply you can say adding in a population, moving in a population and moving out from the population. Emigration is moving out from the population. That is called emigration. Now population density. Now I am going to represent the population density. What is population density? Suppose here it is population density, immigration. Immigration means adding. That is called immigration. Immigration means coming to a population. That is called immigration. So the movement of an individual to a population, increasing what the population density. And emigration means moving out. Emigration means moving out from the population. That is what here it is add plus, and this is negative. part, that is moving out. Emigration is moving out from the population is called emigration, and moving into the population is called immigration. And this is for the natal stress. So this is called mortality. What it is? Mortality. Mortality means what? Mortality. Death from the population density. That is called mortality. That is, it stands for symbol minus. Why minus? Because the number of individuals getting decreased due to death. That is called what? Mortality. And adding. This is called natality. Natality means number of individuals increasing in a population density due to birth. That is called natality. So population density comprising three, four factors are there: immigration, mortality, and natality. Natality, the symbol of natality is positive, and immigration is positive, and immigration is negative, and mortality is negative. Now the formula for the population density stands for in this way. The formula is NT equal to N naught plus B plus I minus D plus E. This is called what? No? Population density. NT stands for population, increasing population in a given area. Increasing populations. Not increasing population, it is population density in a given time. Population density. Now, NT stands for population density. NT stands for population density. N naught, initial population. Okay, B and I stands for, B stands for birth or natality, I stands for immigration, that is dispersal. Next, E stands for emigration, that is also dispersal. So these four factors are responsible for population density. Suppose I am giving you a numericals. How to solve the numericals? Suppose in a population, what does the initial population, in initial population, that is N naught, that is the initial population. Suppose there is 1000, that is number of individuals in a given area is 1000. That is initial population. Now, immigration is adding to the population, that is 10. Suppose this is an example I am giving you, an example. Immigration, that is number of individuals adding in a population, is 10. E, number of individuals moving out from the population. Suppose I, natality, N or D. Suppose birth, natality. Suppose 6, and mortality or death is 3. So what would be the population then? What would be the value of NT? Now this NT will be the populations of the given time, of the populations increasing in the given time would be what? N0, the value of N0 is 1000, so you have to put here 1000 plus B. B is what? B is, that is 6. 6 plus immigration 10 minus death is, or mortality 3, and immigration 5. So the NT, the value of NT would be 1000 plus 6 plus 10, that is 16, minus 8. So 1000 plus 16 minus 8 is 8. So 1008. Okay. So the value of the NT in the given area would be 1008. Okay. So this is called the population density. Next. Age pyramid. What does the age pyramid represent for? Age pyramid sorry, wait. Age pyramid. Age pyramid is comprising three factors, that is pre-reproductive number two, reproductive number three, post-reproductive. So three factors are representing what the age pyramid. So pre-reproductive, reproductive, and post-reproductive. Now this is the structure of triangular age pyramid. Triangular. First is triangular, then after that bell shaped. Triangular, bell shape and arm shape. Now, here it is representing what these are the factors or these are the components in a triangular age pyramid. Now, triangular in. So, here it is what pre-reproductive. What it is? Pre-reproductive. Pre-reproductive. And this is what the reproductive. And this is what a post-reproductive. So what these factors stands or what these factors are involving to forming a triangular pyramid? So triangular age pyramid, that is post-productive. So pre-reproductive. So compared to reproductive and post-reproductive, pre-reproductive, the abundance in this phase which having a most abundant, that is the pre-reproductive. Which phase is having a pre-reproductive is there and reproductive is just declining, then after that post-reproductive is declining. But in this case, there is a certain chances of increasing of population. There is a chances of increasing a population. Why increasing the population? Because after reproductive, reproductive state is over from an individual, then it will attach to a post-reproductive. In case of post-reproductive, it will not form a good individuals, but there is a full chances of producing a pre-reproductive to attend into a reproductive, where they will attempt to mature a different kinds of individuals, and they will produce, enables to produce lot of individuals from that of pre-reproductive. So triangular, it represents there will be a chances of increasing of population. Why increasing of population? Because here the abundance is what the pre-reproductive phase is abundance, and reproductive phase is just declining from the pre-reproductive, then after that post-reproductive is declining from the reproductive phase. So pre-reproductive, there is a chances of to become a, so there is a chances of pre-reproductive individuals to become a reproductive individuals. As a result of that, there will be an increasing chances of what? Individuals in case of primary. But in case of bell shape, what is in bell shape? This is the structure of what of bell shape. Now, what happens in bell shape? Now, here is pre-reproductive, this is reproductive, and this is post-reproductive. So, here pre-reproductive and reproductive are sharing an equal quantity. Which one? Pre-reproductive and reproductive, attaining a same component. As a result of that, there will be a a chances of decline. So there will be a chances of decline because reproductive will finally it goes to post reproductive phase. Then this pre reproductive will again will goes to reproductive phase where there will be no chances of increasing the number. So it will remain what is stable. It will remain what is stable. Okay, here increasing, stable, and here what is declining. Okay, increasing in case of triangular there is a chances of increasing a individual, increasing here stable. What happens here? Here remains stable. Why remains stable? Because pre-reproductive is similar to what to post-reproductive. As a result of that, when the reproductive will attends to post-reproductive, then the pre-reproductive will just displace to what to reproductive state. As a result of that, there will be no chances of increasing so populations or individuals abundantly. So it will remain same. As a result of that, it remains only stable. But in case of unsafe, what happens in unsafe? Here, look at here. Pre-reproductive. It is pre-reproductive and reproductive. And here it is post-reproductive. 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 Look at here. Here, in case of pre-reproductive, the number of individuals are less than the number of individuals in reproductive phase. Okay? Where in unsafe the pre-reproductive, in pre-reproductive conditions, the number of individuals are comparatively less than the reproductive. As a result of that, when these reproductive individuals are attending to post-reproductive, now these pre-reproductive will displace the reproductive to attend in these conditions. As a result of that, the reproductive conditions will get reduced. Okay, in case of unsafe, it is declining. What happens? It is further declining. The populations get declines. Okay, this is the age pyramid. Next, growth model. What is growth model? Now different kinds of organisms attend in a different modes of reproductive phase where as a result of that there will be chances of increasing or sometimes it will be decreasing. That is called what to growth model. It happens due to what? It happens due to climatic factors, temperatures. Okay? So that is called a growth model. Now growth models are two types. One is S-shaped growth model. S-shaped growth model. And another one is J-shaped growth model. So what happens in J-shaped and S-shaped growth model? And the S-shaped growth model is also called S-shaped growth model and J-shaped growth model. Here is S-shaped growth model. Suppose I am giving an example of S-shaped growth model. Suppose a number of yeast, if a number of yeast are allowed to grow in a laboratory or in a culture medium, it will goes on increasing as a due to the abundance of water nutrients. If in a culture medium, if you are going to increase the number of individual of yeast, so you have to culture within a laboratory. As a result of that, the number of yeast will get increasing. Okay, so what happens when the number of yeast get increasing? So here I am showing you in a graphical way. So S-shaped growth curve now here time in hours. Which examples I am giving you? Yeast growing in a laboratory. Suppose there are a lot of individuals are there in yeast growing in a laboratory. In two, the time in hours, here it is mentioned the time in hours and here the number of
yeast cells increasing. Suppose here it is 2 hours, 4 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours, 14 hours, 16 hours are mentioned. So in 2 hours, 2 and half hours, there is an increasing rate in this. This is called increasing of populations in a yeast. How much it is increasing? Near about 120. 120 yeasts are growing in a given time. So what is the time? That is 2 and half hours. 2 and half hours, there is the increasing chances of growing of yeast is 120. Then, so this has this phase is called what? No? Lag phase. What it is called? Lag phase. Which phase is called? Lag phase. Which phase? Lag phase. So, how many phases are there in SF growth model? 5. That is called the S phase. That is what? So, here it is called the lag phase. Lag phase is what? No? That is, initially the populations are growing. The populations in a laboratory, the yeast are growing. Okay? That phase is called what? Lag phase. Then after that, lag phase, that 2.5 hours, then 6 hours is there. Between the duration of 2.5 hours, 6 hours, what is the time period between the 2.5 to 6 hours? That is 3.5. So in 3.5, it has grown up to what? Where? It has grown up to 600. Where it has grown? It has grown up to 600. So this phase is called what? This is called positive acceleration phase. Which phase? This is positive acceleration phase. Acceleration phase. This is called positive acceleration phase. So within 3.5 hours, number of individuals growing is 600. This is called positive acceleration phase. That means the result of the populations of individuals, the number of individuals of each are increasing rapidly. So this is called what? Positive acceleration phase. Then after that, 6 to 10 hours, that is the 4 hours. So in 4 hours, there is a chances of increasing a lot. So this phase is called what is exponential phase. Which phase is called? This is exponential phase. Which phase? Exponential phase. Remember it. In S-cell growth curve, so 5 phases are there. Okay, that is S stands for what? Sigmoid growth curve. How many phases are there? 5 phases. Lag phase, positive acceleration phase, exponential phase. Then after that, the 10 to 14, the duration between 10 to 14 hours is that is for 4 hours. So in 4 hours there is a decreasing amount of decreasing individuals are there. So the individuals are getting decreasing. Okay? So this is called one more stationary phase. Not stationary phase, negative acceleration phase. Which phase? Negative acceleration phase. Acceleration phase. This is called what? Negative acceleration. First one is what? Here, lag phase, then after that positive acceleration phase, then exponential phase, then negative acceleration phase, and from 14 to 16, now we have observed that there are no more yeast are growing. No more yeast are growing. Then it remains what? The same. Okay? Here the curve of the remaining part of the curve and the line of this axis are parallel to each other. Now, this would be what? Stationary phase. What is stationary means? That the number of individuals are not forming, stationary phase. The best examples of S-shaped growth curve is example is growing in a laboratory. So yeast growing in a laboratory is the best example for S-shaped growth model. How many phases are there? 5 phases are there. Remember it. How many phases are there? I'm writing again. How many phases are there? 5 phases. First is lag phase, number 2 positive acceleration phase, number 3 exponential phase, number 4 negative acceleration phase, number 5 stationary phase. How many phases are there? 5 phases are there in S-shaped growth model. Okay, so exponential phase. Per Verrills logic curve. Okay? Variance per logic factor. Okay, curve. Variance per logic curve. Which phase is called exponential phase?
Which phase? Exponential phase. The other name of exponential phase is called variance per logic curve. Okay? Here, exponential phase, this curve is called variance per logic curve. Okay?
So what does this stand for, variance per logic curve? I'm showing you. So, population density. Population density equal to dn by dt is equal to what? Rn. What it is? Rn. Or Rn into k minus n by k. Okay? So, while finding out the population density, so this is the equation you have to follow. Dn by dt. Dn by dt was dn by dt equal to change in populations or increasing in population. Dn by dt equal to R. R stands for intrinsic rate of natural increase. R stands for intrinsic rate. Intrinsic rate means that is the organism which is growing naturally. Intrinsic rate of natural increase. Natural increase. Next. N stands for populations. Okay, N stands for population. Now, K minus N by K. This is the environmental resistance. What it is called? Environmental resistance. Environmental resistance is the environmental resistance. It is a factor which it is inhibiting for the growing of a individual. What are the factors? Droughts, lack of resources. So these are what? Environmental resistance. Environmental resistance means if there is a number of organisms that is increasing in any area, if there is lack of sources and that kind of sources are not permitting a certain species to feed. That is called what? Environmental resistance. K minus N by K. So, dN by dt is equal to change in population. The R is equal to intrinsic rate of natural increase. N stands for population size. Okay? Now, K minus N by K, that is what? Environmental resistance. Now, you will be asking me about what is called K. K is what? Carrying capacity. K is carrying capacity. What is called carrying capacity? Carrying capacity means? Carrying capacity it stands for a natural resources which helps for an individual to feed. That is called what? Resources which helps for an individual to grow in a given area. That is called what? Carrying capacity enables a species to grow. Whereas environmental resistance, that is K minus N by K, that is called environmental resistance. If the number of individuals are increasing in a given area, as a result of that, so there will be a lack of shelters, food. Okay, so such kind of conditions have hampers for the organisms to grow individually, so grow very rapidly further. So that's called environmental resistance. So the equation stands for the S cell growth curve is dN by dt equal to Rn or R equal to Rn into K minus N by K. K minus N by K stands for carrying capacity. K minus N by K stands for environmental resistance. R stands for natural rate of, so intrinsic rate of natural increase. Intrinsic rate of natural increase, that is the population having the ability to grow by itself. That is R, and N stands for populations. Increasing as R factor is permitting for a population to grow, then N will also grow. And K minus N by K, it will resist a organ, it will resist by the environment for a certain organism to grow very rapidly. That is called K minus N by K. Clear? This is called the population density stands for, and these kinds of these
type of, and this is the equation which it is mainly concerned to, which kind of curve, that is S-shaped growth curve or sigmoid growth curve. Okay, so next is left J-shaped growth curve. What happens in J-shaped growth curve? J-shaped growth curve. Here two phases are there. One is one left phase. Suppose the best examples for J-shaped growth curve are reindeer. What is called reindeer? Reindeers are the mammals which are found mostly in the polar regions. Okay? So these are the herbivorous mammals which are found mostly in the polar region, just like a deer. These are called reindeer. Now, in a decade means one decade equal to 10 years. One decade is equal to 10 years. Now, in a decade, suppose one decade, two decade, three decade, four decade, that is 40 years. Now, in a one decade, suppose the population is increasing 100, then after that 200, here all what I have mentioned you, 400, okay? Now, in a decade, suppose one decade and here it is 15, in 15 years, the reindeer are increasing up to 100. What it is increasing? Increasing up to 100. Then after that, within, here one, so for 15 years, number of individual which it has increased is 100. Then after that 2, here 1.5, then here it is 2.5. Between 1 year, between 1 decade, within 1 decade, that is within 10 years, after 10 years, here it has grown very rapidly, okay? It has grown very rapidly, which has increased the number up to 400, above 400. So this kind of growth model is called J-shaped growth curve. J-shaped growth curve. Here in this phase, this is called lag phase. Lag phase. And this phase is called exponential phase. Which phase is called exponential? Remember it. In both the growth model, common is exponential phase. Why exponential phase? Because carrying capacity is enabling for an individual to grow very rapidly. That is exponential phase. Exponential phase. So how many phases are there in J-shaped growth model? Two phases, lag phase and exponential phase. Okay? So this is the best example which I have given you of J-shaped growth model is reindeer. It is a herbivorous mammal which is found mostly in the polar regions. Okay? Now, 15 years, the number of individuals which has increased above 100. Then after one decade, that is 10 years. After 10 years, there will be an observation has seen that number of individuals has soared up to more than 400. That is called what? Why it has increased? Because carrying capacity has permitted for an individual to grow very rapidly in which phase? That is exponential phase. Remember it. Now, reindeer, it is obeying J-shaped model, but in case of S-shaped growth curve model, it is also related to human also. Human can control their birth. How? In case of S-shaped growth model, suppose there is a lot of resources are there and the human having a lot of populations, and after increasing the population and they incur no space and no food and no shelter for themselves. So for this reason, they have to control the birth rate and they have to measure the population. By this way, there will be a decreasing of the population by attaining which kind of phase? Acceleration phase and stationary phase. So human also goes under which kind of growth model? S-shaped growth model. But in case of reindeer, okay, so J-shaped growth model, initially lag phase is there, that is lag phase, then after that exponential phase helps for what happens for what happens during exponential phase? Carrying capacity enables for a reindeer to grow very rapidly in exponential phase. If there is exponential phase is increasing very rapidly, then there will be a lack of source. So that there will be a lack of natural resources, food and shelters, which doesn't help for the further reindeer to grow very rapidly. As a result of that, there will be a chances of starvation for reindeer. As a result of that, the reindeer will get perished by themselves. So this is the difference between S-shaped growth model and J-shaped growth model. Okay? Now, this chapter is over.